When we think of tsunamis, we imagine large waves sweeping away everything in their path. It seems there is no limit to these waves, as some exceed 1,700 feet in height, and some can even destroy several countries or lead to the extinction of entire species. Let's take a closer look at these waves. In this video, you will see the most powerful tsunamis in human history. But before we begin, make sure you have subscribed to the channel and hit the bell icon to stay updated with future content. The Mega Tsunami in Lituya Bay, Alaska. It feels like all the most destructive natural disasters occurred long ago, centuries and millennia past, but not tsunamis. The most powerful of them occurred relatively recently in 1958 in an atypical location for tsunamis in Alaska. The Mega Tsunami in Lituya Bay was colossal. The wave height indeed exceeded 1,700 feet, and incredibly, despite its immense size and power, the disaster almost had no casualties. It all began on July 9, 1958, when a very powerful earthquake of about magnitude 8 occurred near Fairweather Mountain, approximately 13 miles southeast of Lituya Bay. The earthquake triggered a rockfall, which eventually turned into a massive landslide. More than 30 million cubic meters of mountain rock fell into Lituya Bay, leading to the formation of a mega tsunami. The largest wave essentially swept the bay out towards the ocean, then rose up the slope, reaching a height of 1,720 feet. For comparison, the wave height of the infamous tsunami in the Indian Ocean did not exceed 98 feet. The mega tsunami in Lituya Bay is still considered the largest in history, with its force accurately recorded. Since I mentioned the tsunami in the Indian Ocean, it's worth talking about it too. Although the wave heights were far from the largest, as in Alaska, they were sufficiently devastating to make this tsunami the most destructive and deadly in modern history. As always, it all started with an earthquake, with the epicenter located in the Indian Ocean. Following the underwater tremors on the morning of December 26, 2004, the tsunami began, with monstrous waves rapidly advancing inland, devouring everything in their path. At their peak, the waves reached 98 feet, but on average, they were lower. However, this was enough to cause damage to nearly 24 countries. Southeast Asian countries suffered the most, but the effects of the underwater earthquake were felt far beyond this region. Scientists calculated that the power of the Indian Ocean tsunami was 1,500 times greater than the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. It's no surprise that the tsunami devastated the coastlines of many countries, turning them into rubble. Unfortunately, it claimed the lives of hundreds of thousands of people. After that sad December day in 2004, scientists around the world exerted maximum effort to prevent such mass catastrophes and to promptly inform people about upcoming tsunamis. This helped but did not completely solve the problem. Just over 6 years later, another major disaster occurred in Japan. Yes, this is the 2011 earthquake, the strongest in Japan's known history, and one of the most powerful in world history. Its magnitude exceeded 9, nearly the maximum. But the disaster didn't stop at the earthquake. Waves began to roll in, already large at sea, and when the tsunami approached the shore, the wave height in some places reached 33 feet. As with the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami, the elements began to destroy and tear apart coastlines. Many settlements were wiped off the face of the earth. In some cities, thousands of homes were flooded, and in Sendai, which suffered the most, water flooded areas up to 6.2 miles from the coast. Moreover, the earthquake and tsunami led to a major accident at the Fukushima 1 nuclear power plant. The disaster itself claimed the lives of over 20,000 people. Despite Japan's advanced capabilities, the country is still dealing with the aftermath of this nightmare. Indeed, the Japanese earthquake also impacted several countries, with tsunamis observed in New Zealand, Canada, the USA, Chile, the Philippines, and Russia. Speaking of Russia, it experienced one of the largest and most destructive tsunamis in history. On November 5, 1952, a grim day dawned for Kamchatka and the Kuril Islands. A powerful earthquake, the strongest in Russia's history with a magnitude of about 9, struck the region. This earthquake led to the North Kuril tsunami. The city of Severokurilsk was almost completely wiped off the map. The tsunami destroyed nearly all settlements in the area, claiming over 2,000 lives according to official data. Only a few buildings survived, and those were situated on higher ground. The entire eastern coast of Kamchatka and the Kuril Islands, which was also devastated, suffered greatly. Not surprisingly, as the wave heights reached almost 66 feet, the ocean even washed ashore giant blue whales, which were later found amidst the ruins of destroyed settlements. Interestingly, this disaster was kept secret, and newspapers didn't report on it. The first scientific information about the tsunami was published in 1958, and details about the damage emerged only in the early 1990s. Tsunamis can destroy entire settlements and lead to the extinction of species. You might have guessed that I'm referring to the event that led to the extinction of the dinosaurs. Approximately 65 million years ago, a 9-mile-wide asteroid struck the Earth, landing on the Yucatan Peninsula and creating the massive Chicxulub crater. The impact was of monstrous force. To give you an idea of the scale, it was 2 million times stronger than the Tsar Bomba, the most powerful thermonuclear device ever. The asteroid's fall triggered a tsunami nearly a mile high, which might be a record for all time. In the Gulf of Mexico, the wave moved at a speed of about 89 miles per hour, and within the first 24 hours, the tsunami engulfed the entire Atlantic. Large waves swept across the world. Besides, the asteroid's fall caused shock waves and ejected a massive amount of burning rocks and dust into the atmosphere, leading to forest fires and long-term darkness on the planet. This cataclysmic combination ultimately led to the extinction of the dinosaurs and forever changed the planet. Giant tsunamis are just one of many natural disasters, as there are also earthquakes, landslides, avalanches, hurricanes, and many others. These can be even more dangerous and terrifying. Continue watching to see other most destructive, insane natural disasters of all time. The Great Chilean Earthquake. Tsunamis are often inextricably linked with earthquakes, so let's start there. Statistically, about 20,000 earthquakes occur annually, averaging 55 a day. Some go unnoticed, some make the news, and some become highly destructive and record-breaking. The leader in this regard is still the Great Chilean Earthquake, the strongest earthquake in documented history with a magnitude of 9.5. It occurred on May 22, 1960. The powerful tremors were felt over an area of 7,722 square miles and caused a tsunami. The waves were very large, reaching 33 feet in height and spreading far from Chile. Some even reached Hawaii, Japan, and the Philippines. As a result of the cataclysm, Valdivia was almost completely destroyed, leaving millions homeless, and the country was severely damaged. However, the number of victims was not as high as it could have been in such a disaster, mainly because the main impact hit sparsely populated areas. Hurricane Isabel. Moving away from earthquakes and tsunamis, let's turn to equally destructive and spectacular catastrophes, hurricanes. Hurricanes are always something terrifying and powerful, but not all can compete with Hurricane Isabel. It was the most powerful and deadly tropical cyclone that raged in the Atlantic Ocean in September 2003. It formed on September 6th, and just 5 days later, the wind speed in the vortex reached 165 miles per hour. The hurricane was classified as the highest category. It only reached American territory on September 18th. By that time, it was not as powerful or fast, but the weakened Isabel easily devastated many settlements. North Carolina suffered the most, along with South Carolina, Virginia, and Maryland, which bore the brunt of the damage. Millions of residents in these states were left without electricity for several weeks. Interestingly, the hurricane not only destroyed settlements, but also washed away part of Hatteras Island, turning it into what is now known as Isabel Inlet. The Huascarán Avalanche. Escaping an avalanche, like a hurricane, is challenging, especially if it's the most record-breaking avalanche in history. Such an event occurred in Peru in the last century, more precisely, two such events. In 1962, an avalanche descended from Mount Huascarán into the town of Yungay. Yungay was fortunate as the glacier passed by, sparing the town significant damage. However, dozens of neighboring villages were permanently destroyed. It said lightning doesn't strike the same place twice, but Huascarán proved to be an exception. On May 31, 1970, a powerful earthquake occurred in the region. A massive chunk of ice and rock broke off from Mount Huascarán, it was 0.93 miles long, with a volume in the tens of millions of cubic meters. In just a few minutes, the glacier traveled 10 miles, reaching the Santa River, blocking it and reversing its flow. This time, Yungay wasn't lucky. The city was engulfed by the avalanche. Huge ice blocks and rock debris swept through the town, destroying everything in their path. About 30,000 people fell victim to this terrible disaster. The avalanche itself set a record in its kind, unfortunately, in terms of destruction. And let's conclude this issue with the disaster that was the most destructive in 2021. Hurricane Ida became that disaster, a Category 4 Atlantic cyclone that raged in late August to early September. It struck the southeastern part of the states, with Louisiana suffering the most. Over 70% of the state lost power, leaving millions of homes without electricity, and the Mississippi River changed its flow direction. The cyclone brought a tremendous amount of rainfall. Heavy rains flooded the first floors of buildings and halted metro services. The aftermath was even felt in the northeastern part of the country. In total, more than 100 people died, and the damage caused by the hurricane was unparalleled in 2021, estimated at $75 billion, with the aftermath still being addressed. In the comments, share the most terrifying catastrophe you've witnessed in person. Also, if you found this interesting, don't forget to like and subscribe.